My name is Divanshu Patil. I am the student of SVIFS Institute of Forensic Science, and today I delivered my topic Raman Spectroscopy and its forensic applications. My topic is Raman Spectroscopy and its applications. As we know that this is very essential for India because this is discovered by Indian scientists C.V. Raman and K.S. Krishnan in 1928. Raman spectroscopy is based on the scattering of light. The Raman spectrometer consists of number of principal components, a light source to produce the incident light, a prism or a mirror and focusing lens to direct the beam toward the sample, and a spectrometer for the detection of scattered light. Principle: using a light source, a beam of monochromatic light is introduced to the sample. The light is influences on a substance, the majority will be there. If the light is absorbed or passed through the sample, there are two ways of scattering: elastic scattering, also known as Rayleigh scattering, and elastic scattering, also known as Raman scattering. Elastic scattering. In elastic scattering, occurs a photon in its virtual energy state. This state is very short, and the molecule soon returns to its ground state, releasing a photons of equal energy to the initial photon in the state. There is a no loss and gain of energy during this process. And the wavelength of the scattered light and excitation source is same. In this diagram, the yellow arrow indicates the light source, red arrow indicates the Rayleigh scattering, and blue arrow indicates the Raman scattering. In elastic scattering, when the light is impinges on the sample, then the energy is gained or lost by the scattered energy. The difference between the incident photons and scattered photons is called Raman shift, in which the energy is lost. This is called Raman stroke shift, or energy is gained, that is called Raman anti-stroke shift. These shifts are detected and transferred into a virtual representation of the data gathered. In this, the Raman spectrum plots the intensity of Raman shift versus the frequency. The Rayleigh scattering, where there is no energy gained or loss, stroke Raman scattering, there is a loss of energy, and anti-stroke Raman scattering, there is the gain of energy. There are same inks with different colors indicate their peak values. Instrumentations. Raman spectroscopy have major components: first, light source; second, optical fibers; prism, mirror; the third one is wavelength selector; and fourth, detector. A sample is normally illuminated with a laser beam in the UV visible or near infrared range. Scattered light is collected with a lens and it's sent through entrance filters or spectrophotometer to obtain Raman spectrum of a sample. Raman instrument: laser, lens, sample, filter probe. We select the wavelength of laser, spectrophotograph which detecting the scattering, and computer which plots the graph of scattering data. Forensic application of Raman spectroscopy. Raman spectroscopy is mostly used in forensic science. With the help of Raman spectroscopy, we detect and compare two different things, and chemical analysis of ink is done on Raman spectroscopy. The chronicle sequence of ink contribution also detected here. Dyes, pigments, solvents and liquids of inks are also detected by Raman spectroscopy. Chemical composition of different inks are detected, which is made by different inks. Raman spectroscopy is used for dispute writing cases. The alteration on the dispute cases are easily detected here. Raman spectroscopy data help to classify 9 investigation instruments into 5 different groups based on their characteristic peaks. There we shown 9 different inks in 5 groups with their characteristic peaks on the instrument.